always considered this to be my safe space and genuinely don't feel that safe here anymore. I'm a commitment phobic. I really apna account delete karke nikal jati yahan se. I've never even shown this side of me. It's scary to be in love with me. Pura din baith ke YouTube dekhne unko sab samajh mein aata hai aur mere messages unko padhne samajh mein nahi aate hai. Bahut like bisa bura saaya jaisa chal raha tha hamari puri family pe. I will not change my authenticity for anyone. When are you guys getting married? Hi you guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. For today's video, I'm doing a life update and Q&A. Maine questions liye hai Instagram pe and I'm gonna answer them plus give you all a life update here and there somewhere because there was a lot that happened in August through my social media and I feel like I need to talk about certain things over here, clear the air and just, you know, get things back in momentum before I dive into any more vlogging and sharing of things with y'all. So I really feel like this video is long overdue. Y'all have been commenting that we are feeling a little disconnected with you. I'm not connecting to your vlogs and I've been seeing those comments. I feel like this video is a little overdue. I feel like we need to chat. We need to have this heart to heart. So without any further ado, I'm actually filming this for the second time. Maine pehli baar makeup karke isko film kiya and it was not successful because neither could I concentrate on the makeup nor on the story. So now I'm done with my makeup and now I'm chatting with y'all. If you're interested, then continue watching. But if this is the first time you've come onto my channel, then hi, I'm Sarah. I make beauty and lifestyle videos here on YouTube. Take a moment, hit that subscribe button, join the Sarah squad. I'm sure you love it here. And also don't forget to hit the bell icon right next to you so every time I upload a video, you get notified. And with that, we can dive straight into this. I'm also going to end up keeping a timer. 5 bajre mein 6 bajre ka alarm rakhne wali hu. Varna, I will be talking here for ages because the questions I have here are a lot, okay? There are a lot of questions. Let's try and see ki main kitne questions answer kar sakti. Right off the bat, pura scroll karte samay, what I can see, the most common thing people are interested to know about right now is, can you please share about how you and Reeth met, yours and Reeth's love story, how you met Reeth, your full love story, are you in a relationship, is Reeth your boyfriend, Reeth is the hot topic right now, which is not what we wanted. So I'm gonna share as much as I feel comfortable and then I'm gonna leave the rest to time to tell you all. Okay, right off the bat, I want to say that this is not a couple channel and it is not going to turn into a couple channel. So I don't feel like Reeth and I sitting here and sharing our love story makes sense to my audience. Maine aaj tak aise questionnaires meri family ke saath bhi kabhi nahi kiye hai, meri team ke saath bhi kabhi nahi kiye. Unless it's Impulses channel, we don't do Q&As. Unless it's Mummy Logic, I don't do Q&As with Mummy on this channel. I feel like Sarah Sarosh's channel should be about Sarah Sarosh. But of course, if Reeth is such an important person in my life, y'all are gonna have questions about him, which is very, very fair and square. But the person that I'm dating is a very private person. Reeth does not like his life to be out on the internet. So for me to share anything about him, his profession, his family is not right. It's not my place. Even though he's important to me, for me to protect his privacy is also bahut bahut important mere liye. And I want to respect that boundary with him because of course, as much as he respects me and he's, even though being a private person, allowed me to put him on camera in my vlogs, which is a huge thing for him, right? Imagine somebody who does not like to be on camera being in vlogs. So he's also becoming comfortable with this side of my life and I also want to meet him in middle over here and draw a boundary ke talking about his life over here should not be allowed. Kal ko unko agar baat karni hai and if he says samne se ke Sara, yes, let's do this, I want to talk about it, I want to start a couple channel with you, I want to do things with you on social media, that's a different thing altogether. Him saying, because I have been doing this since ages, donkey's years at this point. I've seen social media evolve in so many ways, right? Like I came here when I was mere 18-year-old girl. Today I'm a 25-year-old woman literally and I'm here on social media. Main khud badi hui hu social media ke sath aur maine usko bada hote hue dekha bhi hai. To mere liye ye meri ragon mein behta hai. Like maine social media ka pyar bhi bahut dekha hai, nafrat bhi dekhi hai, sab kuch dekha hai. But for him everything is very, very new and this entire industry is like what even recently happened with me when he saw the extent of it, he was really taken aback ke wow, like, you know, shit really goes down when shit goes down and people really elevate you when people elevate you. So he's seen both the sides of the coins with me because we've known each other for a really long time. So which is why again, I can't share our love story. It's a cute love story, but I can't share it unless he's gonna sit with me and do that. So it's not gonna happen in the near future, I'm pretty sure. Inshallah, dekhenge kisi din. So again, this is a topic we're not tapping into a lot. I know y'all came with that expectation ke Reeth ke baare mein bahut baatein hogi. I just want to say ke at least this much I want y'all to know ke don't assume things about a person jab main nahi bata rahi. And y'all have met my entire family, my best friends, my team, everyone through vlogs and got to know them through vlogs. Everything about their life here and there, whatever I can share with y'all, you know, in real life. It's not like this या मूवी सीन्स एंड हम सेट्स क्रिएट करते हैं और हम स्क्रिप्ट लिखते हैं, ऐसा नहीं है। मेरी एक्चुअल जिंदगी आपने मेरे साथ जी है, आप मेरे साथ बड़े हुए और आपने ये सब उनको देखा है। सो जस्ट लाइक दैट ट्रीट रीत एज अ न्यू पर्सन इन माई लाइफ दैट यू ऑल विल गेट टू सी हिम इन व्लॉग्स योर एंड देयर, गेट टू नो हिम एंड गेट टू स्पेंड टाइम विद हिम एंड आई एम श्योर एज यूल स्पेंड टाइम विद रीत यू ऑल विल फाइंड आउट थिंग्स अबाउट हिम दैट यू विल रिलेट टू एंड यू नो फॉर्म अ बॉन्ड विद रीत इन योर वे जस्ट लाइक यू ऑल हैव फॉर्मड अ बॉन्ड विद एवरीवन हु वाज इन माई व्लॉग्स। इवन माई एक्स टीम मेंबर्स यू आर सो क्लोज टू माई एक्स टीम मेंबर्स ऑल्सो एंड माई बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स हु आर सेटल्ड ऑल अब्रॉड। आई नो दे मैसेज मी एंड देयर लाइक दे सब्सक्राइबर आज ट्रेन में मिली थी, दे सब्सक्राइबर आज मेट्रो में मिली थी, जो मेरे बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स अभी व्लॉग्स में दिखते भी नहीं है बिकॉज वो सब अब्रॉड सेटल हो गए, बट दे ऑल यू आर ऑल बॉन्डेड विद ऑल ऑफ देम थ्रू माई व्लॉग्स। सो जस्ट गिव रीत दैट टाइम टू गेट कंफर्टेबल इन दिस स्पेस, डोंट हाउंड हिम विद क्वेश्चंस कि अभी आप लोग को सब कुछ जानना है, बिकॉज आई फील लाइक सर्टेन थिंग्स व्हेन ट्रीटेड इन द राइट वे इन द राइट टाइम नाइसली विथ टाइम आर मोर ब्यूटिफुल। सो स्पेंड टाइम विद दैट पर्सन। आई मिस द क्वेश्चंस बिकॉज दे कीप कमिंग। व्हाट डिड यू सी इन रीत दैट अपील्ड द मोस्ट टू यू फॉर यू टू टेक दैट लीप ऑफ फेथ? ओके, I'm a commitment phobic and anytime anybody is shown any affection towards me, I've ran in the opposite direction. I've honestly never wanted to date consciously. I love reading love stories, okay? If you've ever seen my book recommendations, they are all these hopeless romantic love stories. Yashraj is my favorite person of all time to exist, to make all those romance movies in Bollywood that made me fall in love with love in the first place. So you all have always only seen the boss girl side of me, the career-oriented side of me. You've not seen this side of me because I've never even shown this side of me because I kept it trapped in one dabba because I felt like nobody in this actual zindagi deserves that pyar because सब लोग कंडीशनल होते, प्यार अनकंडीशनल होता ही नहीं। मैंने मान लिया था कि प्यार अनकंडीशनल होता ही नहीं है, इट्स ऑल कंडीशनल। सबको तुमसे कुछ चाहिए, कुछ मतलब है, कुछ मतलब निकालना है, इसीलिए ही वो तुमसे प्यार करेंगे। सो आई हैड मेड दैट माइंड सेट। माई मॉम यूज़ टू ऑलवेज टेल मी कि किसी दिन कोई ना कोई होगा हु विल अंडरस्टैंड यू, हु विल रिस्पेक्ट यू, यू कांट फुल्ली वैनिश द आइडिया ऑफ लव। सो इफ यू हैव सीन द मम्मी लॉजिक एपिसोड ऑल्सो वेयर माई मॉम एंड आई डिस्कस रिलेशनशिप्स, आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट माई कमिटमेंट फोबिया एंड हाउ आई एम स्केर्ड ऑफ रिलेशनशिप्स एंड माई मॉम वॉज सेइंग जस्ट बिकॉज एक पत्ता खराब निकला तो पूरा झाड़ खराब होगा जरूरी नहीं है, जस्ट बिकॉज यू आर स्केर्ड ऑफ द एंड रिजल्ट यू विल नॉट टेक दैट लीप ऑफ फेथ इज नॉट गोना बी यू नो हाउ यू रोल अबाउट विद लाइफ। लाइफ इज अनसर्टेन येस एंड पीपल change, yes, and चीजें होती है यार, होती है, इसलिए relationships break and you know you never know why a relationship didn't work out because it's not always the people that didn't work out for each other. कभी कभी लोगों के timing सही नहीं होते और इसलिए भी नहीं होता है। So all of this I've seen and वो सब में I just wanted to protect my heart from all of this and I've always wanted to protect my heart from anyone. But I feel like Reet just thawed his way into my heart, like slow and steady he broke off, like he took his own sweet time and broke off all those cold hearted chips from me and really warmed his way into my heart because for me that major leap of faith was the amount of respect Reet has towards me no matter how different he is from me. Like I said, he's such a private person, he really likes to guard his personal life, he doesn't like to share anything, and then he fell for me. Like I was like, bro, I'm an open diary on the internet, you don't want to fall in love with someone like me because I am, it's scary to be in love with me because why do you want to, like I literally used to be like, why do you like me, like what is there, you know? So it was, I'm very weird like that I didn't want to believe that he actually is liking me and he's getting attached to me and I was also getting attached to it. So it was a very slow process, but yeah, we've had our fair share of everything. For me, when I took that leap of faith was when I saw the utmost respect that Reet has not just towards me but towards everybody in my life. Unki aankhon se dikhta hai ki it is not wo dikhave wala, like he's such a simple guy that he doesn't even care what I am, who I am, kya hai mere paas, kya nahi. Because I have met people in the past who just wanted to get associated with me because I was an influencer and then unko bhi social media pe grow hona tha. So that's the reason that they wanted to get associated with me. Y'all don't really know Reet. Y'all have just seen him thoda bahut in vlogs. And it's just sad ke koi koi log already itne assumptions karne lage uske baare mein. Reet and I very much are two independent, financially independent people. He has a very good job and he pays his own bills and I have a very good job, alhamdulillah, and I pay my own bills and we don't need to be dependent on each other. And even if we were at any point in our lives, I don't think it's for y'all to decide who's a sugar mommy or who's a gold digger. I think these are such harsh terms to use. If you didn't have money and you borrowed from a friend, or if you know you borrowed from your parents, did you become a gold digger? just harsh words y'all are using against a person y'all don't even know. So it's sad. Y'all are not even trying to get to know such a nice person. But anyway, for the people who've shown love, I know we've received a lot of love. Mashallah, mashallah. Like, I show Reet all of your nice comments also. Like, I make him realize, because sadly for him, he got discovered on Reddit well before my Sara squad even met him. And Reddit, of course, everybody's just in a hate club and in a hate zone. So they were character assassinating him. And that's how his discovery happened, because somebody did major jasusi into my life and found him and put screenshots of his LinkedIn and his Instagram and everything on Reddit. And puri uski privacy ki violation ho gayi thi puri tarike se, jab tak maine unko dala bhi nahi tha vlogs mein. And that's how he was introduced to the world of social media. After seeing that kind of comments, he felt like him coming into my life is only going to create negative comments on my vlogs. But with my Sara squad coming in and commenting and showing so much love to Reet and I, it's really warmed our hearts and made him realize ki achhe log bhi hai internet pe. Aisa nahi ki sirf bure comments aate hai, achhe comments bhi aate hai. I think insaan ki niyat aisi hoti hai na ki wo buri cheezon pe hi zyada dhyan chala jata hai. Mera bhi jata hai. Mere bhi kitni baar main aadha time hate comments pe itna dhyan deti hu ki I forget ki there's so many people who are loving me and who are supporting me and are still there for me. So yeah, that is the leap of faith and a little bit about Reet and I think I'm going to take the relationship questions only. Sabse pehle one more question I will take over here is about how did he meet. I'm just missing the questions over here. I hope I can find them for the screenshot. But there was a question asking, how did I introduce Reet to my parents? Now, if you all know, my parents and I share a very candid relationship. Alhamdulillah for that also. Because my parents have raised me to share every, especially my mom. My mom always wanted to be my best friend. And she's, I think, accomplished that. Like for me, even if I went on a casual date, I would tell my mama I'm going. Okay, I'm meeting this person. I would send a photo and everything. And I would come back and discuss the date also with her, even if it went bad. So I've actually discussed everything of my life with my mom. And even about Reet, when he came into my life also, I'd shared with mama everything. So mom saw all the phases of Reet and my relationship evolve, like an onion layers, you know, like she saw it happen. So she loves Reet because she's seen all the layers of Reet through my eyes and she loves him. So she's seen him through me, Vesa. But my dad is definitely very close to me, but I think wo thoda respect boundary to hota hai ki papa ke sath sab nahi share kar sakte. Papa ke sath matlab tabhi ladke ko leke jayenge jab haan ladke mein kuch dam hai. Aise randomly koi bhi ladke ko main nahi leke ja sakti papa ke paas. So Reet was the first person I took to my dad and I was like, okay, I'm dating him and I don't know where it's going, but it could go somewhere, like, you know, that kind of a person. And dad appreciated that, like, he likes Reet and then they've spent a lot of time together and now I think dad likes Reet more than he likes me also. So that was like a proper official introduction that dad and Reet had, like man to man, and things were like that and it was pretty cute for me to watch on the sidelines and see them get along. There was such a core memory in my mind. If Bali was your first trip with Reet, how did you feel about it? We've always seen you travel with your parents. Bali was the first international trip Reet and I had, which is why the currency exchange, I was very surprised how easily he was handling the currency exchange, because he's also traveled internationally alone and I've also done it alone. But of course, saath mein humne internationally ek bhi trip nahi liya tha abhi tak. We've taken mini trips over here in India, jo maine kuch bhi vlog nahi kiya hai. I used to get away with him for some time and just spend time together. So that has happened. But international trip, we've not taken any. So ye Bali ka trip lamba, sabse lamba trip hamara Bali hi tha. Different, I would say, from parents, definitely very, very different. And again, here I want to say that my mom and dad also fund themselves financially and Reet also can fund himself financially. This is not that I am some sole bread earner of the entire khandan and everybody associated with me. I don't know what y'all think, jo bhi travel with Sar mein aata hai, uska paisa Sara hi deti hai. Aisa nahi hai. Because I also have limited funds and limited income. With my parents, because they are older na, to un logo har cheez ke liye, like, you know small things, like main baba ko bolti tum Google Maps dekh sakte ho, so he knows how to read Google Maps. He's like, main chashma lana bhul gaya. So fir even when I'm walking, I have to see the Google Maps also, I have to balance the tickets also, I have to balance this also. And even though I've sent them all the tickets and kept on the WhatsApp group, my parents will not open that WhatsApp group and check the tickets. Kitne baje ki flight hai kal kitne baje nikalna hai, kal kitne baje ka train hai, kal kitne baje, like by the end of the trip with my family, I'm like, guys, मैंने सब WhatsApp पे भेज के रखा है, खोल के देखो तुम लोग, कुछ भी खुद से नहीं करते. तो they become very like bachas with me and they become very dependent on me, because जले अरे अभी तो text आ गई दुनिया, हमको कुछ समझ में नहीं आता. पूरा दिन बैठ के YouTube देखने उनको सब समझ में आता है और मेरे messages उनको पढ़ने समझ में नहीं आते. So these are my parents and मेरे बीच में जो वो होता है. Reet के साथ ये सारा कुछ भी दिक्कत नहीं था, because he's my age, so Google Mapping, financing, ये सब वो सब. Even papa handles money very easily, so papa के साथ भी मुझे cash में problem नहीं आता था, Reet के साथ भी मुझे cash में problem नहीं आता. They all handle money very effectively. But Reet used to handle the Google Maps and communicating with the Airbnb host ho gaya. So if I am not talking, if I tell him just message the Airbnb host, he can also do it because Airbnb I have added him also on the conversation and kept. So it's just as good as traveling with a person your age, you know, like when I travel with Sharon or Sakshi or Dikshi or anybody my age, also this ease of travel is there because these people are also my age, so they can communicate with these things very easily. Whereas mummy papa become literally like kids and they become dependent on us very easily. But yeah, it's fun nonetheless. Dono ke saath bahut maza hai. How are you doing? And hope you're fine. Auntie's leg fracture update. How is she and how is Fudge? So I haven't vlogged in a very, very hot minute. I haven't picked up the camera. I am vlogging now. September, I started vlogging. August was really a blur. So it was a little difficult there for me also mentally. Mom's leg is also stuck, like it's literally not healing because of menopause. Unka bone calcium density bahut kam hai, so her fracture is technically not healed at all abhi tak. 2 mahine plus ho gaya aur unka fracture bilkul heal nahi hua hai. So that's a sad part of her fracture healing process jo atak hi gaya hai. I genuinely feel like hum sabko itni buri kisi ki nazar lag gayi hai ki bahut like bisa bura saaya jaisa chal raha tha hamari puri family pe in the month of August. And as for Fudge ka tick fever is completely better now, alhamdulillah. His full medicines are completed and CKD ka we have to do a follow-up. Uska abhi tak we've not done a chronic kidney disease ka follow-up, but I've told you all right, it's a progressive disease, so far there's no update as such. He's functioning just fine. He's right here sleeping, so he's functioning fine, alhamdulillah. Same person has asked 2 questions which are very relevant. Do you think your content is going to change after the recent backlash you faced? Are you still going to be as authentic or are you going to be a little scared to post your opinions now? Okay, so I have so much to say, yet I'm gonna really keep this short about whatever happened was my mistake, right? My poor judgment. And I took upon full responsibility for it. Jitna bhi mujhe backlash aaya, I deserved it because maine galti ki thi. Aur maine kabhi bhi nahi bola hai ki I am not going to make mistakes over here. Main itna content banati hu aur itna apna life share karti hu ki galtiyan hogi. Main bhi insaan hu, mujhse bhi galti hogi. Bahut buri aur badi wali galti hogi, bewakoofi ho gayi, you know. Sabse bada word for me later when I was just constantly reflecting over my actions, I was like, what were you thinking, Sara? That was my biggest question to my own self. But I also had to ask myself, were my intentions wrong? Because if that would have been there, I would have honestly cancelled myself. Like if I would have done this for PR or publicity or any, if I would have used a topic as sensitive and as critical as a rape to attract views and publicity and fake PR for myself, agar maine wo karne ki koshish ki hoti, to main khud apne aap ko cancel kar deti, really apna account delete karke nikal jati yahan se, because I don't deserve to be here. But that was not my intention. Mera intention sachi mein yehi tha ki I just wanted to talk about this सब्जेक्ट. मैं ऑनेस्टली ऐसा बात नहीं करती हूँ पब्लिक ओपिनियन में. आप लोग ने आज तक मुझे न्यूज के बारे में बात करते हुए देखा ही नहीं होगा क्योंकि मैं खुद न्यूज कंज्यूम ही नहीं करती हूँ. मैं बहुत अपने बबल में रहती हूँ व्हेन इट कम्स टू दिस पब्लिक अफेयर्स, बिकॉज़ मेरी मेंटल हेल्थ बहुत अफेक्ट हो जाती है. आई नो इट्स अ रॉन्ग थिंग टू डू, यू शुड बी वेरी ऑफ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द वर्ल्ड एंड स्टफ, बट कॉन्स्टेंटली रीडिंग अबाउट टेररिस्ट अटैक्स एंड रेप्स एंड क्रिमिनल अटैक्स एंड ऑल इन द न्यूज रियली अफेक्ट्स माई मेंटल हेल्थ एंड मेक्स मी फील लाइक हम कैसी दुनिया में रह रहे हैं. एंड इसलिए मैं ये सब चेक ही नहीं करती हूँ. बट ये जो रेप केस हुआ था मुझे एकदम deeply affect kiya tha. So I really wanted to talk about it, but my approach was so stupid that I put like an old get ready with me edited on this audio that I had filmed that morning of what I was feeling about the incident. I was feeling like if she was my friend, this had happened when I was going to college, so mujhe kaisa lagta aur main logo ko kya jawab deti aur kaise is cheez se deal karti. Maine ekdam personal touch dekhe, matlab main actually wo sari cheeze feel kar rahi thi. To agar aap sirf audio note sunte na wo reel ka, to usme actually meri aawaz mein dard hai. But maine jo video li, wo maine purana video लेके उसको डाल दिया एंड विदाउट थिंकिंग टू मच, विदाउट थिंकिंग ऑफ द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस, आई जस्ट पोस्टेड इट. एंड विद इन 5 मिनट्स व्हेन आई सॉ लाइक 7 कमेंट्स वर देयर, एंड 7 कमेंट्स में से 5 वर लाइक दिस इज सो डिस्टेस्टफुल सारा, इट्स नॉट ट्रांसलेटिंग, प्लीज डिलीट इट. मैं समझ गई कि पीपल आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग इट द वे आई वांट टू डिलीट इट इमीडिएटली. मैंने ब्रॉडकास्ट पे डाला कि आई एम नॉट अ न्यूज रिपोर्टर, आई एम अ ब्यूटी क्रिएटर. तो मैंने सोची मुझे ऐसा डालना है. मेरा इंटेंशन लिटरली यही था कि मुझे उन लोगों तक पहुंचना है जो मेरे तरह ब्यूटी कॉन्टेंट या एज अ टाइम पास कॉन्टेंट ही कंज्यूम करते हैं, मीम कॉन्टेंट. लाइक मैं इंस्टाग्राम पर जाती हूँ, बकवास चीजें ही देखती रहती हूँ, लाइक जिससे मेरा टाइम पास हो, यू नो, एमलेस स्क्रॉलिंग करती हूँ. मैं कुछ भी, कोई भी न्यूज पेजेस को फॉलो नहीं करती हूँ, कोई भी सोशल एक्टिविस्ट पेजेस को फॉलो नहीं करती हूँ, बिकॉज मुझसे वो देखा ही नहीं जाता. सो फॉर पीपल लाइक दोज ऑल्सो हु कंज्यूम कॉन्टेंट लाइक मी जस्ट फॉर टाइम पास, शुड बी एबल टू लिसन टू दिस इंसिडेंट, बिकॉज ये इतना बोन चिलिंग इंसिडेंट है. इसलिए मैंने ऐसा रील बनाया था कि वो एकदम टाइम पास कॉन्टेंट में, बट मैं स्ट्रॉन्ग मैसेजिंग देकर चली जाऊँ. तो मेरा इंटेंशन ये था, बट वो जिस तरीके से पूरी तरीके से फ्लिप हो गया ना, लाइक I instantly saw that people are not receiving it in that way, so I deleted it. But once a screen recording is taken and it's gone viral on the internet, there is no curbing that wildfire. I saw that coming and I saw the consequences and I had to apologize. Okay, sentiments hurt too, and if I have hurt somebody intentionally or unintentionally, I'm gonna apologize. So my apology was very much from the heart, and the consequences I got, the backlash I got, I deserved it, because y'all saw that reel. There were poor actions, poor choices. I didn't even show it to my team. I didn't show anything. It was a very impulsive posting, you know, just like I'm doing. Like, kabhi kabhi you just do things, you just say things, and it was just like, I feel like I must have not fully grasped the, like, I feel like I understood my influence after that reel. Ke shit, my one small action can cause such a big stir if it has to. So I really truly understood that. And uske baad jo backlash aaya, jo mere subscribers se aa raha tha, wo main puri tarike se le rahi thi. Jo random log threats deke ja rahe the, usse of course I got very scared. Because once something goes viral on a platform like Reddit and Twitter, which don't really have any community guidelines, like Instagram and YouTube have a lot of community guidelines to protect a person, but these platforms like Reddit and Twitter are all about anonymous posting, anonymous commenting, and all the वहाँ से बहुत सारे लोग आके rape threats कि तू rape होएगी तभी तेरे को समझेगा और तेरे साथ ही होएगा तभी तेरे को समझेगा तेरी पूरी ज़िंदगी like कितना कुछ like cancel सारा सरोज was the least of the problems. These rape threats, murder threats, and dirty things being said, Reet being messaged things like I hope you know what your woman has done and I hope you give her a tight slap for it, and not one woman, multiple women actually messaged Reet and told him, a person who's just been introduced on my social media, they messaged Reet and told him that he should hit me so that he can put sense into me, like yeah. And then if there was ever a domestic violence case, these women would again come up and, you know, become social activists about this. So it's so ironic that while we were fighting for a women's safety on the internet on one side, we were again making a woman feel unsafe on the other side by telling her own partner to hit her and, you know, commenting about my family and giving me rape threats. Like, I literally shut down all social media for 10 days and also shut down going out of the house. I literally apne aapko ghar mein band karke baithi thi, ek hi jagah gayi thi mere salon mein, because everybody there knows me. I went to the salon, safe place, came back at home, and 10 days I was at home. My friends came home to make me feel better, my family kept visiting me, everyone just kept coming and checking in on me, and I took my time to heal from the incident while also really realizing my mistake. Yes, I did make a big mistake. And will I change after this? Will I change my content after this? I am protective now, that I can say. Because when this all happened, as much as I came, I took it. What I really didn't like is how my family, friends, Reet, all of these people got dragged into it. For them to be dragged into this was unwanted. But I didn't do this. I have put all of them in vlogs, I have shared all of them with you, so you all include them. My family is saying something bad, saying my family's safety is at risk. I didn't leave my house, my mother, my papa, Ishan, they all said to stay at home, that God don't do it, something happened outside, so you never know what can happen, right? It's not safe to God. So everybody, like, if something happens to me, everyone is at risk. So I was telling even Ishan, I was so scared for my family in those days. I was literally going down on my knees and just asking for forgiveness for my actions and praying to God so fervently for the safety of my family. I was genuinely really scared just for the safety of my family. So that really shook me to the core, ke I was scared for them and I was scared for my family and friends and everyone who got dragged into this, even when they didn't ask for it. So khud ki galti jab sirf khud ko jhelna pade, wo ek cheez hai, and I know they are worried for me, but I was mostly worried for them. And that way I am gonna get little protective about my family and what I share on the internet about my family, because that's the thing with YouTube content, you end up sharing so much and you don't know the boundaries, the lines become so blurry. With Instagram short form content, chote snippets of your life, yahan wahan ki story dal di, yahan wahan ka photo dal diya, ho gaya. You don't have to give a backstory about everything, you don't have to share clips and clips of something. I've always been overshare on YouTube. I've always considered this to be my safe space and genuinely don't feel that safe here anymore, because now a lot of people consume my content and then pick on things and come to, you know, comments. Just is tarike se mera confidence kuchla gaya hai na us period of time mein, ke jo personal vendetta bhi logo ko mere vlogs ke through tha, sab kuch laake they removed it in the comment section, and itna harshly they've commented so much, like, because I have only given you access na into my personal life. So I was regretting so much in those those days ki I was like, shit, I should have never vlogged this. Shit, I should have never put my family out there. I should have never made this. I should have never become a vlogger. I should have stuck to beauty content. Like, mujhe bhi bahut sare regrets feel hue. So currently I'm in a little bit of a gray area, a gray zone ke if I vlog, how do I draw the boundaries? How do I draw these lines? And how do I reinvent things in my content? Will I still say authentic? Yes, I will. Just one mistake and just some backlash cannot. Like, you can make as many cancel Sara Sarosh videos and boycott Sara Sarosh videos on the internet, but I know that my true community, I have created more than 1200 videos on the internet, just long form. Usse zyada short forms, usse zyada content maine banaya hai 7 saal mein is community ko banane ke liye. Maine bahut mehnat ki hai yahan tak pahunchne ke liye and bahut imandari se mehnat ki. Aaj tak ek bhi video aisi overnight viral ho ke main kuch fame nahi ikhatta kiya apne liye. Bahut bahut imandari se kaam karke yahan tak pahunchu. To kabhi bhi main kisi ko bhi janbujh ke hurt karungi nahi ki views jama karne ke liye. Agar wo sabhi karna hota main kab ka karke famous ho gayi hoti. To ye sab harkatein mujhe karni bhi nahi aur ye sab main karungi bhi nahi. Main insaan hu, mujhse galti ho gayi. Maine sorry bola. Wo sorry bhi आप लोगों को जेन्युइन नहीं लग रहा था, बट मुझे पता है कि मेरे दिल से आया था. मैं सॉरी बोलूं ही नहीं अगर मेरी गलती नहीं हो. आई एम गोना एंड अप डूइंग अ लॉट ऑफ वर्क इन एडिटिंग फ्रॉम नाउ ऑन टू मेक श्योर आई रियली रियली कॉशियसली एडिट. तो आई इवन बाली के व्लॉग्स बहुत नेचुरली कैंडिडली सब शूट हुए थे, बट बहुत कुछ मैंने काट दिया था फ्रॉम द व्लॉग्स. जो भी ऐसा बहुत ज्यादा प्राइवेट मोमेंट था या बहुत ज्यादा बहुत ओवर शेयर कर लिया था मैंने या कुछ भी ऐसा था, दोज ऑल पोर्शंस आई कट आउट बिकॉज नाउ आई विल बी अ लिटिल मोर हैवी हैंडेड इन द एडिटिंग. शूटिंग में अभी भी जितना हो सके ऑथेंटिकली करूँ, बिकॉज अगर ऑथेंटिसिटी मेरे से ले लिया तो फिर क्या मजा आएगा. बिकॉज दिस इज हु आई एम. आई हैव ऑलवेज बीन रॉ एंड रियल, नॉट जस्ट इन ब्यूटी कॉन्टेंट, इन लाइफ स्टाइल, इन माई एक्सपीरियंसिस, इन माई ट्रेवल्स. आई वॉन्ट सारा सरोज टू बी नोन एज अ रॉ एंड रियल क्रिएटर एंड आई विल नॉट change that. I will not change my authenticity for anyone. I was scared, but I am not scared anymore. I am going to be protective of my family, but at the same time, if they are comfortable with certain boundaries, I will happily share those moments with y'all. But yeah, content is definitely going to change more towards beauty format content because that is something I had in goal. Time for the next question. How do you overcome your negative thoughts or mindset? I personally pray a lot. I am a very, very strong believer of God, of the higher power. And this time when everything happened, I was in such a dark space that I have prayed to all the gods to remove me out of this. Like, I don't see religion, I don't see God's names, I don't see anything. Main dil se dua karti hu, matlab dil se I pray. I strongly believe that I'm God's child and I pray for forgiveness with all my heart. I pray for blessings. I pray for strength through the suffering because this is a suffering of life, right? Life aisi रहेगी तो कितनी बोरिंग हो जाएगी. सबकी लाइफ में ऊंच नीच आता है. प्रे फॉर स्ट्रेंथ टू राइड थ्रू दैट. इट गिव्स मी एंड पुट्स मी इन अ पॉजिटिव माइंडसेट टू लुक एट थिंग्स दैट देयर विल ऑलवेज बी लाइट एट द एंड ऑफ द टनल. ऑलवेज. किसी की भी जिंदगी पूरा टाइम डार्क हो ही नहीं सकती है, किसी भी जिंदगी पूरा टाइम लाइट हो नहीं सकती है. सबकी जिंदगी में ऊपर नीचे ऊंच नीच सब आते रहेगा. सो ऑल आई आस्क इज फॉर स्ट्रेंथ एंड forgiveness, a lot of forgiveness, because all of us are sinners, okay? Nobody is very this doodh ka dhula hua. Do you feel at home in your new house or is it still sinking in? I very much feel at home. Now my home is alhamdulillah my safe space. I mujhe ghar chhodna hi pasand nahi. I'm literally all the time in my home. This beautiful light. Look, I can't stop looking at myself in the mirror. The sun is perfectly shining on me. I love it. Why are you changing your behavior because of hate comments? We love to watch the old you. Guys, I'm not changing because of hate comments. I'm not changing because of anything. I'm changing because time is passing. I am not the same person you all used to see anyway because main badi ho rahi hu yaar. Main change ho rahi hu as a person. Main change ho rahi hu. Meri priorities change ho rahi hai. Meri lifestyle change ho rahi hai. Mera sab kuch change ho raha hai. To aap log bar bar sab logo pe blame karte rehte ho, but actually koi bhi mujhe change nahi kar sakta hai. But halaat aur time change karte rehte hain insaan ko, and change is a good thing. I don't know why every time I've seen this with other creators also, the minute they start changing due to a person or something, that person starts getting backlash and all. It's not right because you can't expect me to still be 18-year-old in medical college struggling and balancing med school and vlogging and doing beauty content. But wo ek alag time tha meri life ka. Then I grew out of that. I came into vlogging and beauty content. Then I started my own business. Now I'm in a different place altogether. Alhamdulillah, I have bought a house. It's not like I don't have struggles today, but my struggles are very different. Now I have a home loan to pay. Now if I have losses, they are in major, like lakho ke nuksan hote hai, lakho ke kharche hote hai. Har cheez ekdam alag numbers mein deal ho raha hai. Main badi ho gayi hu. तो हर चीज मेरे अराउंड चेंज हो गई है। पहले मेरे बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स थे, हम ड्राइव पे जाते थे, हम मस्ती करते थे, इधर उधर रहते थे और टाइम पास करते रहते थे। तो मेरे सारे बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स अब्रॉड चले गए, सब अपनी अपनी लाइफ में स्ट्रगल कर रहे हैं। अभी हमारे अडल्टिंग वाले प्रॉब्लम्स चल रहे हैं, अडल्टिंग वाला फेज चल रहा है। तो ये वाले फेज में मैं आप लोग के साथ कैसे रिलेटेबल रह पाऊँ, आई डोंट नो, बिकॉज इट्स लाइक यू आर आस्किंग मी टू स्टिल स्टे इन द बैकवर्ड व्हाइल लाइफ एंड टाइम कीप्स मूविंग फॉरवर्ड। एंड आई एम नॉट चेंजिंग ड्यू टू हेट कॉमेंट्स, आई एम जस्ट गोना बी कॉन्शियस अबाउट व्हाट आई शेयर, कांट शेयर इट एज अनफिल्टर्ड, बिकॉज अगेन नॉट जस्ट माई सब्सक्राइबर्स हैव एक्सेस टू माई कॉन्टेंट, राइट? अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल कैन वॉच माई कॉन्टेंट एंड फिर वो लोग काफी चीजों को ना ऐसा 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 ट्विस्ट मरोड़ करके अजम्पशंस बनाते 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 जाते हैं। दैट्स द सैड पार्ट ऑफ सोशल मीडिया, दैट विद टाइम यू हैव टू ट्रीट इट एज अ प्लेस दैट यू कांट बी एज ओपन। विद अ बिग फॉलोइंग कम्स अ बिग रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, क्या आपको फिल्टर करना ही पड़ेगा अपना कॉन्टेंट, वरना आप सब एकदम ओपनली शेयर करते रहोगे, वो लोग वैसे ही उसको ट्विस्ट एंड टर्न करके अलग अलग थ्योरीज बनाते रहेंगे। इसलिए काफी बड़े क्रिएटर्स अगर आप देखोगे, वो लोग हर चीज शेयर करने से पहले हजार बार सोचते और करते भी नहीं है यार। नॉट अ लॉट ऑफ द बिग क्रिएटर्स हु मेड इट नाउ इवन शेयर वेयर दे ट्रैवल और व्हाट दे डू और व्हाटएवर, दे ओनली कम डू ब्रांड कोलैब्स एंड लीव। एंड दैट्स आल्सो नॉट अ थिंग दैट दे आर डूइंग कॉन्शियसली, उनको करना पड़ रहा है बिकॉज उन लोग कुछ भी अगर पर्सनल डालेंगे दे आर गोना गेट अजम्पशंस एंड बैकलैश एंड वियर्ड थिंग्स एंड हु वांट्स टू हियर ऑल ऑफ दैट अबाउट देयर पर्सनल लाइफ, राइट? सो इट्स जस्ट विद टाइम आई हैव टू चेंज, इट्स अ कोर्स ऑफ नेचर, चेंज इज अ पार्ट ऑफ नेचर। एंड नाउ आई थिंक द लाइट इज जस्ट वियर्ड, वेरी वेरी वियर्ड। नाउ द क्लाउड्स आर गॉन सो द सन इज रियली हार्श। When are you traveling with your parents this year? I really don't know because my mom has fractured her leg. It's such a sad thing कि हम पता नहीं कब travel कर पाएंगे. Because any place you travel, you have to walk so much. And mummy currently सिर्फ घर में, literally सिर्फ घर में रहते हैं with her air cast. She's not moved anywhere. It's just very sad. I don't know when I can go again with my family. Somebody said Reet is so Wattpad coded. I used to read Wattpad as a kid. Of course, after your relationship is revealed, the next hot question is marriage plans soon. When are you guys getting married and all of that? I have no idea guys, and bahut time hai, please hamare pe pressure mat dalo, hum bacche hai abhi. Okay, the sun is setting now and the battery is down, so I'm gonna end the vlog over here. I hope you all enjoyed chatting with me. Meri coffee bhi khatam ho gayi hai, so all of these are signs that we need to close out for today's video, but I hope you guys enjoyed. This was a long overdue chit chat session and I really feel good talking to you all after so long. I hope you all enjoyed watching. If you did, don't forget a big thumbs up. For this video, subscribe Goshi Chitarte Mohapatra. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video, subscribe, you know what to do. Subscribe button, bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad. And just remember my next video, Sara Squad shout out. Somebody also got up from his sleep. This is the right time to say bye bye to Sara Squad. Bye you guys, we'll see you next time. Mwah. Kichu give, mwah.